This is a pulp mill. The main production processes at any pulp mill are the fiber line, where fibers are extracted from wood, the recovery island line for chemical recovery and energy retrieval, and the effluent treatment line. Wood, the main raw material, comes from controlled, sustainably managed sources. Logs are weighed, measured, and inspected. From the wood yard, logs are fed into a debarking drum and chipper. The chipper cuts logs into chips. The bark is used for renewable energy. Conveyor belts transport the chips to storage piles, after which they are transported to the digester. Wood consists of fibers embedded in lignin. During the fiber line process, these two main components are separated and lignin is removed. The chips are taken into the digester, where they are mixed with an alkaline solution, white liquor, and cooked in high temperature, which dissolves the lignin and separates fibers. Black liquor is a liquid that consists of dissolved organic material and spent cooking chemicals. About half of the wood raw material is dissolved in the black liquor. Black liquor is sent to the recovery line, where organic matter is burned to energy. The digester produces pulp that is brown in color, caused by lignin residues. After cooking, the fibers still contain some lignin, which must be removed to ensure low environmental impact bleaching. To preserve pulp strength, the lignin must be removed selectively. There are several washing stages in between the different process steps. The purpose of brown stock washing is to recover dissolved organic material and chemicals used in previous stages and reuse them. High washing efficiency with a low amount of added fresh water is essential during this water-consuming process. Bleaching increases the brightness of the pulp so that it can be used in paper products such as printing grades and tissue papers. Chlorine dioxide and oxygen-containing chemicals are used for bleaching to mitigate environmental impact. Washed, screened, and bleached pulp is taken next to the dryer. The dryer is a high complex setup of different equipment and systems. The drying machine produces thick and heavy sheets. Dryers are able to produce up to 300 bales of pulp in an hour. Draining, pressing, and evaporation removes water from the wet pulp. Dry pulp bales are easy to transport and used by different industries. Sheets are packed in bales, taken to storages, and then transported to markets all over the world. Chemical recovery is a crucial component to the chemical pulping process. It recovers process chemicals from the spent cooking liquor for reuse. Black liquor is evaporated to a high dry solid content in a multi-stage evaporation plant, where steam evaporated from the previous stage is used in the next stage, resulting in an energy-efficient evaporation. Condensed water is reused, forming a closed loop in water usage. In softwood production, soap is separated from the black liquor. Soap is then converted to crude tall oil, which is a renewable source for biodiesel and bio-naphtha production. Evaporated black liquor is burned in the recovery boiler to recover the inorganic chemicals for reuse in the pulping process. It also generates high-pressure steam to generators for electricity production and low-pressure steam used in different processes in a pulp mill. The energy production of a pulp mill is not only enough to make the process energy self-sufficient, but it provides power to the national grid as well. In addition to being a powerful fuel, organic lignin is a versatile biomaterial that helps to reduce dependency on fossil-based raw materials. Black liquor residue, molten smelt, is a solution of sodium carbonate and sodium sulfide. It is mixed with a weak wash, resulting in green liquor. During the re-causticizing process, green liquor is treated with a burnt lime and converted back to white liquor. White liquor is returned back to the cooking, and the lime is recovered in a lime kiln and reused again. Effluent treatment is at least as important of a procedure as pure water intake and availability. All wastewater is treated in mechanical and biological effluent treatment plants before being released back into watercourses. A typical treatment plant first uses gravity to separate suspended solids, and then biological treatment to convert biodegradable organic matter into simple substances and additional biomass, which can be further used in energy generation or as a fertilizer. Airborne emissions are monitored continuously. Most of UPM's airborne emissions result from energy generation. We aim to continuously reduce these emissions, and improvements are especially visible in sulfur dioxide and nitrogen dioxide emission reduction. The main components that are released to the atmosphere are steam and carbon dioxide, which is later absorbed by the natural cycle and turned to oxygen by trees. We continue to reduce these emissions by choosing non-fossil fuels and investing in new combustion and purification technology. To learn more about our production, products, and sustainable forestry, please visit upmpulp.com.